Sit down back 1, 1 plus 2, right? Animals does this clown have? Combo if you delay it. But the label's good, I guess, because it does, it sets up, this roll better. So that shield is probably the fastest move out of that, right? Okay, it doesn't crush highs of force, but it's in some Link Xiaoyu shit. Kind of hard to react this time. Oh, hit. On block, though. Sidewalk everything out of that roll if you're early enough. We got shenanigans with this, but I have a suspicious feeling that you could use this as a juggle and then to force the mix up. Right? So if I were just like. Low whiffs. catches that direction. So it does force it. It does force it 50-50, but staying down the side, rolling in one direction, keeps up both options. Yeah, to your right. So it's kind of gimmicky. Well, I suppose that's one way you can use this, other than using it in a neutral, which is also really gimmicky. Right, so
can we use Jumbo Ender to force roll mix-up? Except versus side. Grounded side.
Next, we got down back two. Which is the low spear. How fast is this? Very slow, I'm assuming. Okay, not that slow. It beat out something. Sick. Of course, that's gonna beat it out. Sick. Fuck, what was the slow move I had? Oh yeah, dial back one plus two. Sick. So it beats out that, I think it was a 23 frame move. Sick. Sick. 24 frame move. Sick. And loses a 20 frame move. Sick. 13 frames? Sick. Alright. Sick. 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 What's a plus on block stuff? Sick. Sick. Big plus. What about on hit? Sick. Yeah. Sick. Yeah. Plus one. Sick. Oh, that's something in here. Plus four, right? Sick. 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 Damn. This sick. Data is so weird. Sick. Plus five sick. On hit, not four to one. So let's try that. Sick. So this is plus five on hit. I'm gonna go 16 frames. Okay, so I lost that. 17 I don't have to work. 18 frame loses, so 17 would exchange. And a plus 5 situation. So plus 5. 17 frames. This is a 22 frame low. Maybe it's not seeable. The animation is a big tub, but maybe it's not seeable. Let me double check a dot 41 is 15 on him.
Glorious! No, I won't give in! I won't give in till I'm victorious!
I like the cut of your jib.
Well, I like the cut of your, taste in streamers. Thanks for the donation. I'm trying to be hyper focused at 4 a.m. and I'm like exhausted, and that was the last thing I fucking expected. But thank you very much, McGwiffin. I appreciate it. I'm gonna double check this being 15 frames. Oh, this crushes highs. Oh, shit. Shit. Forward 4 is 15, right? I think forward 4 is 15. Yeah, it's 15. Okay. Weird to do.
Glorious! No, I won't give in! I won't give in till I'm victorious!
Word.
Thank you very much once again. Alright, so that is plus 5. Confirm it right there, right? So I was right. So the low, the spear low, is 22 frames. So I don't think that's seeable. As far as like speed goes, I don't think that's seeable. The low might be legit. Risky as it is. The only thing you'll get is there's going to be those people that feel out like, oh, it's a lot slower than the general mids that you do, right? But the thing is, like, for example, the mid-spear, that shit is 14 frames. That's a lot faster. So it's going to be, like, this big difference. But when you're just talking about a neutral situation, how we're just dancing around over here, that kind of thing doesn't matter as much. It matters more if it's, like, oh, off of a jab, or this hits you, then I'm going to do this mix-up. That's when the speed difference really matters in two things. So if I just do some stupid shit like this into this, or this into this, there's a big difference there. So that's where it's gonna matter a hell of a lot more. But overall, I don't think this is seeable. But it's awful on block, I know that much. Probably Lanier's how too. Sidestep? Yep, nothing, right? Sidestep. Yeah, it seems really cool, but it's super unsafe, right? So it's like, if I could just not suck for a second. Wow. So it's at least negative 18, not 25. What about 24? I think this is 24. No, it's not 24. Is it 24? What do you mean? Thanks again, McGwiffin, man. I appreciate it very much. Oh, it's 28. That's actually really slow. Shit. This is the thing I hate about, like, trying to test block data for lows. It gets fucking weird. Because it's like, alright, 18 punishes this, so everybody in the game is going to be able to launch this properly, right? From crouching. But then it's like a distance thing, right? I think it's Kazumi has a really good while standing launcher. It's slow, it's 18 frames, but it moves it forward quite a bit, right? Now, if I were to try this with, let's say, Dragon Ball, I mean, his range is pretty good, too. Still, though, it might not reach.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7.
I don't know. Let me think of somebody else. Paul? Paul probably will not be able to launch that.
Paul Phoenix, Noctis Lucis Kylum.
This is while standing, too. He, like, swings that shit upwards like he's trying to fucking palm thrust his chin. That she goes nowhere. And then Wells says he had hop kick. Maybe if I do a shredder's crouching, maybe. I don't know. Whew, okay. Yes. Wow, go figure. Noctis kind of moves forward after it's blocked. So it has good range, but ooh, look at that phantom hurtbox. Oh boy, never mind this. Okay, hawking doesn't work. Ball will always be able to launch. Sounds fair to me. Yeah, it's good. It'd be really stupid if you were just stabbing at your toes with that shit at like the tip range, and then you couldn't be, you know, you wouldn't be able to launch them. That'd be really dumb. So I'm glad they made him at least move forward a little bit, so most launchers maybe could catch him. I can't think of too many people with less range. I don't know, maybe that Paul while standing 2 has actually has deceptive range, maybe? But, maybe has shitty while standing launcher range. Heihachi doesn't have a while standing launcher. Kazuya? Down forward 2 will probably reach. Sorry, while standing 2 will probably reach. Law, maybe?
Martial law. Noctis Lucis Kylum. Get ready for the next battle.
Try this shit. Capo? Maybe Capo, yeah. They got a slow launcher that covers quite a bit of distance, right? Alright, so if we do it like this. So the wall standing. Yeah. He has like a phantom hurtbox during it. It's like a Billy and KOF how his stick is part of his hurtbox. Okay, so yeah, I'm pretty sure the whole cast, if not outside of maybe like 1 or 2 anomalies here and there, outliers.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Edgul of Noctis Lucis Kylum.
So maybe not the 13th frame, but the other one would probably work, right?
Get ready for the next battle.
Moves him forward a lot. Everybody would probably be wrong. I'll call it. Call it as I see it. I'm not gonna go through the whole cast, but.
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Kazumi Noctis Lucis.
I found a pretty good spread of frame data for Kazumi as far as standing goes, so I feel good about using it for this. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20 covered with the zoom. And Even though I'm missing that one gap, that 17th frame, which he probably does have, I just don't know where. All I need to confirm is one slower and one faster, and that's all I really need to confirm what falls in between. So, here we got negative 18. How much is this on hit is the big question. Let's take a forces crouch. It do. I beat out his 15th frame. He beat me out with his 13th frame. So we will exchange if he goes with a 14th frame. Just to be sure, let me find a 14th frame move real quick. I know he has one somewhere. Down 4-4. Okay. That's not much damage. There it is. Plus four. Plus four on hits. Okay. Now I know this has counter problems. Somebody's scraping. So that's guaranteed. Does he get a juggle? One more damage. That's guaranteed. Alright, let's check something here. Has a taunt, he sure does. Nah, just because a character has a taunt, don't assume, you know, that it's like a guard break taunt. That's the thing that's unique to Brian. There's a couple of characters that have taunts, but they don't attack.
Hell yeah.
See? That's his taunt right there.
Hell yeah.
There's no attack.
Hell yeah.
He can't even cancel it in any way. Damn, that would have been sick, right? But well, we know this floor breaks. Damn, too bad his fuse do this like sword slam out of that. That'd be sick for a wall combo. He does have a floor. Nah. The other thing doesn't slam down. Up forward two? Let me go back in there. Sorry. I should try up forward two. Forward two might do it. I do it? Let's find out. Oh, I can't think of anything else. That combo. All running 1+2, huh? Alright. So no floor break off of that. Next on the list, we got a good old low poke. Of course, it's gonna work out. 14 frames? Nice. You got geese style, except with range. A little bit of range. And it's not linear. 14 frame high crushing low. Huh? No counter hit properties though. How is it on block? Negative 12. 14 frame low, negative 12. Let's check for 13. Low poke might be better than I thought. Let's see how it is on hit when I get there. Still don't know anybody with a Bob. Alright, let's check for 13. Does Bob have a 13 frame? While standing 1. Bob while standing 3. 15. You don't. So, he has a 14 frame. Jin? He's got that covered. While standing 1. 13, good.
Jin does not disloose his Kylo.
That's negative 13 and negative 14. Negative 13. So it can be launched by a couple of characters. Capos have a 13 frame while standing launcher, but it's a high. This is recovering crouching. Next. Negative 3, sorry. Negative 2. Negative 2 on hits. So So it's like Jin's down 4. Same damage. It's just like Jin's down 4. Except he recovers crouching, Jin recovers standing. And I think Jin's down 4 got buffed to only being negative 12. It used to be negative 15 or 14?
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist Tournament 7.
So he has a 14 frame low poke that's only negative 13 on block. 13 damage. Block. Negative. Shit, what was it? Negative 2. Negative 2 on hit. High crush. Tracks both sides. So at least Noctis has something for low up close. He does have a decent low. You don't have to go super high risk every time.
Get ready for the next battle.
I was checking to see if he could do it from crouching. Next we got this weird ass low that sucks ass, right? What is this? What is the point of this? You have this. Down back 3. I don't see the point of down back 4. I was hoping it at least only be negative 11, but this shit is negative 12, at least. It does track in both directions, at least. Let's check it. This just seemed like they were trying to fill some sort of core. Like, down back 4 needs to be something. I'd rather down back 4 had been a 12 frame generic low, but I guess they don't want him to have it for whatever reason. See how fast it is. It's slow too. It's 15 frames. Well, it's not slow. Slower than the fucking high crushing load. How is it on hit? Are you kidding me? Minus 2 on hit? Dude, what is this trash? Hits ground, which I should have been checking with these buckets. I forgot to check what hits grounded. Damn, I'm an idiot. Oh. Let's bring out good old Jin again. I just realized Jin has 13 while standing 13, while standing 14, and while standing 15 covered.
King of Iron Fist Tournament 7.
I think he has while standing 12 coming.
Jin Kazama, Noctis Lucis Kylo. Get ready for the next battle.
He could Demo Man, but not only that, Demo Man is a juggle starter in the floor breaks. His Demo Man slams down. Grounded too. I don't. Down back four serves zero purpose. It's faster. All right, we have this launcher. Big boy launcher. High crushes, right? Yeah, for a little bit. The start of it. I got a 16 frame on him. I gotta do this one time. Oh my god. There it is. Cross dash into wall standing launcher. Anyway. Man, who the hell has the range for me to test slower moves?
Welcome to the King of Iron Fist.
I suppose the point being, most people won't be able to punish this, right? Safe to assume. But I want to know how bad it is specifically.
Noctis Luce, Noctis Lucis Kylo.
I mean, I have enough data here to test. Oh, I know a long range 17 frame move I can test. I'll have to use the wall to test slower moves. Got hit by the 16 frame move. I believe that's 17 frames. That's not good. So this is negative 16 with a ton of pushback. This is kind of like Heihachi's forward forward too, actually. Now that I think about it. It ducks highs. Doesn't quite go under mids, it looks like. Yeah, it doesn't quite go under mids. And it's like damn near impossible to punish. Unless you're a Noctis. Then you always punch a punch. Okay, Aaron is down forward 2 is 17 frames and come back for 16. No, I got it covered. It's just a matter of range. Yeah. Well, Noctis, this right here is 17. And he blocked it. Jin's forward 4 is 16 and he got hit by a punish. So, I'm covered. We're good. All right. I don't know about the startup for this yet. Next we got charge.
King of Iron Fist Tournament 7. Kazumi Mishima, Noctis Lucis Kylum. Get ready for the next battle.
Oh, it's plus. +2. Damage too. Yeah. 23 frames starting. That's 24 frame move I'm exchanging with that bear jet. Not too bad considering it's like impossible to fucking punish for some guy, right? Like all that. That might work if I were to like do it right when I recover, but that push block, fuck, that push block makes it hard to time. There it is, see? Punish. So much push block, man. The timing is just super awkward. Alright. So we got that already. Shadow stab. Back two. No, that's back one, so it's just 12 frame punish. Good one. How weird that this is so late on the list. Yeah, 12 frames. No counter hit properties. But does a shitload of damage, that stab. 25 damage on counter hit. Does in jail. Wow, look at that pushback. Does he have any just frame input so far? He has one that I know of. This. Back two, 1+2. I wouldn't call it just frame though. It's like a bootleg just frame that like you got. You probably got a pretty decent window. I tried mashing it before. It's not consistent. It's not consistent when I mash it. See? It was better just the timing. It's like a cadence. Bop, bop. finish. Negative 9. +6 on hit. So the push block on this is the kind of thing where even though it's -9, could set it up to bait whiffs. He didn't even do the right thing. Wow, why did it? What the fuck? It's like a 2D game where, you know, the proximity of my attacks will mess with the inputs for some reason. Doesn't make any sense. There's a linear. Back one by itself and anything special right now. It's not like King's back one, too. Frame mid. Safe mid with the hit though. So this is a 13 frame punish. It's a 13 frame. Yeah. pretty solid. Right, so track step, not walk. Music's done, huh? I don't think so. Negative 9 on block. God, the recovery of this makes it crouch. I can't down forward three, I get a low because of the animation. Plus 4. Plus 4 on hits. I gotta add an hour to my alarm here, and then I gotta call it in about 50 minutes because I have to get ready for school. See if I can, I don't know if I can finish this. Noctis only on a PC. I don't know, Hydrated. I have not checked on the PS4. Oh wow, also plus 4 with the hit throw. Sorry, back 3-1. Frames. Natural combo, normal hit, wall splat. Oh boy. Okay, negative 14. Been a while since I've seen you, negative 14. Welcome back. Hold back on that knockdown, even on counter. What's up, Toka? I think you're feeling hungover. I feel exhausted and I have to go to a class soon. Doing my homework for my midterm, dear. My Noctis midterm. So this, all splat. And armor second hit. Second hit. big old schnoz. Look at that shit. See that Sage Jam he's rocking right there? Look at that. I don't got a mid serve. I was joking. I do have a mid serve next week. Not this week. Just one. My final semester, so. Oh man, his back turn shit. Back turn shit. You can set it up to set up his back turn 2 launcher, but even on hit, it's not great. Turn 2 does hit grounded. There's no tracking on that back 3. Even though it looks like it should have tracking, it's got none. Man, that sucks. Back 4, 1 pursuit. How much longer do I have left? Oh no, my stick stopped working. This is happening to me during I updated the fucking Brooks shit, and now it doesn't. It randomly doesn't want to work on my PC. See? Now it came back. Fuck. Now it's moving down by itself. Fuck. That should happen to be in the middle of a match last time. How much longer do I have left? Man, I got a lot to go. 20 moves? Moves. Let's go through these back moves and then I'll call it. So back 4, 1 plus 2, huh? Excuse me. Sorry guys, I'm like super sleepy. Should have started this earlier. Holy shit. That second hit is no joke. Wow. So it's negative 13? Holy shit. This is a good move. Yikes. Four damage, huh? Frame start. Well, if I didn't update this, I would not be able to use it on my PS4. But I had no choice. No, you can't even interrupt this with jab. As a matter of fact, if you try to, the second hit launches. Big boy damage for a wall splendor, alright? He can't combo. Yeah, he can. I don't know what the wall combo would be, though. Hmm. What the fuck? Yeah, I'll figure this out when I go through some more jungles. Was that Unseeable Low? Well, he has an Unseeable Low. He has a few. He has 14 frame down back three, high crushes. He has his 15 frame shitty low that I would never recommend you use. And then he has a 17 frame demolition, man. That floor breaks in the floor break stage for jungles. And it trips further than the falls. And then he has this shit. Which on counter hit. Give him a free follow up. Oh, did I mention he has a wild running pressure move that starts jungles on normal hit? This is like plus something on block, right? Yeah, that's plus some bullshit on block, right? And then you could get a full juggle out of it. For a lot of damage. Like 70 plus. On normal hits. It's just linear. Alright, shield smash. Back plus one. So back 4, 1 plus 2 is definitely a wall splat, but I don't know his wall combos enough to really... I gotta, like, explore that later. I plan on using it, so I'll probably look for some combos for the next time I stream. That looks like it's gonna be plus on block, I've already guessed. Slower than 20 frames? Never mind, did it? Oh, what the fuck? Yeah, this is really slow. Yeah. This might be like 26 frames. Never mind that, this shit is super unsafe. What the fuck is this? Thought this would be plus. This is negative 11. Hard knockdown. 20 down. Definitely guaranteed. Father. Back plus two plus three. Is that an unblockable? Not much to say here. No track. I feel like an armadillo. Yeah, it's like I'm actually about to call it. I've been at it for almost 5 hours and I have to get ready for class. Ooh, that rain. Damage. Unblockable. Zero tracking. Oh man. It's 5:30 a.m. or something. So yeah. That's what I'm gonna call it. I got like 20 more moves to go through and a bunch of juggles to figure out. But so far, Noctis seems cool, right? His glaring weakness up close is that he's a little stubby up close, I feel like, just with regular strings, regular pokes. But then he has like absurd range where he could fight from back here with like down back and shit. Forward one plus two. He can punish moves from all the way back here with down forward two. Let me go to our open stage. He'll carry you to the wall in like one juggle easily.
Get ready for the next battle.
This song is so sick. Makes you want to load up Yakuza 0. So, up close to dangerous. Do a little run through of what I learned today here.
Welcome to the run down. Noctis Lucis Kylum. Get ready for the next battle. Yeah,
like let everybody else figure it out. Alright, so. Jab punish, 1-2-2. That's your jab punish. It's kind of shitty, because it leaves you at, only at plus one, I think it was, right? Starting from the top. I gotta write this separately for punishers. Alright? Yeah, 1-2-2 is your jab punish. It's only plus one, unfortunately. But, you know, not too bad. He has a standard down forward one, negative one on block. Good range. It looks like it would go under certain jabs because he does a little duck animation, right? And then he has a Dragon style follow that he could delay, right? He could also just do it as up forward four, by the way. But yeah, that forward 1-4, which also, if they hit him out of the air, is a tailspin. And this is also a counter hit straight for 13 frames. So he has that to go with his down forward 1 pressure. Oops. Right? Up close, I would recommend using down back 3 as your main low poke. And then if you want to go for high risk big damage, you do the demolition, man. Down 4, 1, 1 plus 2, which in the grounded stage will break the floor. 17 frame startup, and it tracks your right as Noctis, right? Not to your left. Also, we're fighting against Noctis, and then what the fuck? That run animation is weird. And the load doesn't trip you. Even though that second hit is a high, don't try to duck. If you try to duck, you will get hit, and the whole thing will combo. For 50-something hit. Yeah, for 51 damage. If you try to hold Dom back for whatever reason, the high hits you, and then he'll get the last hit guaranteed. What's this on the previous one? The previous one was Let Me Make You Feel Good, I think it's called. It's from Yakuza 0. Oh no, it's Try to Have Some Fun For Me. That's what it's called from Yakuza 0. It's the Cabaret Club music. So anyway, yeah. So, up close, I recommend using this as just your standard local. 14 frames, tracks both sides, only negative 2, on hit. It's just like Jin's down 4, basically. Only negative 12, I think it was, on block. Or maybe negative 13. But yeah, really good. I think it's negative 13. Whatever. Let me double check. Show F, down back close. 3, right? Yeah. Yeah, negative 13 on block. Right? Yeah, 1-2-2 is your 10 frame punisher. Back 1-2 is your 12 frame punisher. And your 13 frame punisher is pretty much back 2 with the hit throw. Back 2, 1 plus 2. Basically, get the timing now. You can kind of mash it out, but you have to mash really hard. I suppose if you're doing it as a block punch, you mash it out. But if you're doing it a neutral, I would suggest you just do the timing. Because then there's no bigger giveaway than what you're trying to do there. You get what I'm saying? Whatever. 33 damage, plus 4, leaves him standing. Same thing, if you don't get it and you only get the first hit, that's still plus 4. With some pushback, though. That move also happens to track to your right. Yeah, it tracks to your right step, but not walk. Right? So anyway, next we got, for 14 frames, it's forward 3, right? Yeah, forward 3-1. Oh, sorry, back 3-1. Back 3-1 for a high. That's a 14 frame punish. Forward 3-2 if you need a mid. Those are both 14 frame punishes, right? 39 damage, forward 3-2. As a matter of fact, it should only be forward 3-2, I think, because this is less damage. I don't know, it depends on what kind of Oki you want, because it looks like back 3-1 gives better Oki. Right? It does that little ass slide while this one gives you this up close shit, but they can wake up kick attack. Well, I mean, I guess they're both okay, right? 15 frame punish, down forward 2, which has a fucking shitload of range. If you need an easy combo, right? You could just do 4-2. 4-2. 4-2. Mash 2. 4-4-4, right? Easy, easy, whack-ass combo, right? 61 damage, good damage. Good damage for how easy it is, right? So that's that. Anytime you're in a neutral, you can do this slow-ass shit. It's a whip punish, but it's pretty slow. I forget how fast I have it recorded. I think it's 20 frames, something like that. 4 plus 2. Right. So, and this is actually safe. 4 plus 2, I think I have it at a Questa mark, 20 frames. It might start up at 20. But if you need something much faster, 14 frames, forward 1 plus 2. A ton of range for mid. Hard to punish from max range. Don't miss it though. And of course, a little more range than down back 2, but you can mix it up in this game. Down back 2. Forward 2 is a special mid, which is they can block it standing or crouching, but it will, like, connect with them standing or crouching. His forward 2 is 20. Okay, I had that in a question mark. Oh, yeah, forward 3 is nosebleed, by the way. Sorry about that. Yeah, about this. It does do more damage than the high, but forward 3 is nosebleed, which means you can fuck up the second hit if you hold down. So it's not really a punish. Be careful with it. See? And from my testing, I was able to stand up and 13 frame him as a punish in this position. 14 frame I couldn't get, but it could just be my excuse. Sorry, my nose is running. Alright. Yeah, his rage drive is a little faster. I don't like his rage drive. It doesn't do anything special. So yeah. Maybe do the other shit. Fort Sue is also a 12 frame punisher, but it sucks as a punisher, in my opinion. So just do back one two. That's gonna take 15 frames. I haven't gone through the while standing, but I know that while standing 2-2 is your 15 frame launch. So keep that in mind. And then while standing 1-2 is, I believe, 13 frames. While standing 4 is your typical 11 frames. Full crouch down forward 2 to get your full crouch mix up going. And then you can go into it with down 1, which is plus 4 on hit. Down 1 leaves you in crouching, plus 4 on hit if you go into the full crouch mix up. And just in general, I haven't gone through in this video yet, but while running 1 plus 2, very good move. And I already know you can mix it up with fold forward 1 plus 2 for a home safe homing mid that spins, you know, counter hit, gives him a duck. You follow? Wow, that's... He doesn't get it, huh? Go figure. I wonder what the juggle is off of that. I'll figure that out some other time. Yeah, 4-4, 1 plus 2 can kind of mask the while running 1 plus 2. The big boy combo. ...74 damage for a pressure on normal hit. You definitely want that. Oh yeah, really good long range homing move in 1 plus 2. While you're shifting for shit from back here, if you feel like people are like sidestepping you, throughout 1 plus 2, really fast. And it wasn't horrible on block from what I recall. And you can just cancel out the first hit by holding back. Keep yourself safe if you just want a single hit. And it's only negative 2 when you do that. On hit. It's not awful on block either. I think it's also it's negative 9 on block. Tonight. So yeah, that's all I got. Alright, it'll reach his rage drive with wall splash. It's good stuff. So yeah, that's the short of it. Obviously, that's not all he has, but that's just a good place to start. Up close, fish for this, get some of this every once in a while if you need a higher risk, especially in a drop right stage. You can do the 1-2-4 teleport, 1-2-3 teleport to fuck with people. If they swing after the 1-2 on block, they're stuck in the axis that they're stuck in. Unless they do a homing. I'll show you what I'm talking about. One more time. Alright. So if I were to swing. See? I'm off axis. You recover crouching off of these teleports, both of them. 4 to go to your right, 3 to go to your left. So that's how you can mix up 1-2, 1 plus 2, which is safe on block, but can be interrupted by 11, maybe 12, but 11 frames. I know that. So magic force could interrupt you if you do that. So that's just one way to force this mix up, because if people are going to chase you down on a teleport, they have to do something slow. And that opens them up to get hit by this last hit, which does a grip. Right, 23 down. So yeah. And then he has this dumbass slide, It's down back 1 plus 2. Both of these get a down back 1 plus 2. Guaranteed, right? So yeah. Alright guys. Thanks for tuning in. I'll be uploading this to the YouTube. If you scroll down, you know the deal. I don't know when the next time I'm going to stream is going to be, because I have to do a lot of homework for tomorrow. And I don't know what homework I'm going to get in class later today. And then next week is midterm. But I want to finish the Noctis stuff soon. And then I got one more thing with King to do with the throws. So hopefully after the week. I definitely want to finish Noctis soon, in like the next day or two. But like the King stuff I'll go back to later on, like in a week or so. Outside of that, I hope y'all have a good day, because it's day at this point. And thanks for tuning in, y'all. Have a good one.